of martial arts, starting with judo in 1973 at Dr. Baradawala, who expired just a few years back at the age of 104 years. Then I switched over to taekwondo and then hapkido. Meanwhile, I did some other martial arts also, like Muay Thai, and to broaden my knowledge in martial arts, I did several other martial arts, but my main field had been taekwondo and hapkido. We have recently formed the Hapkido Federation of India, and this year only we had the national championship. Shall I sit on top or standing? But I think sitting, this will be a problem. Anyways, now today is our subject, hapkido. Since compared to other martial arts, hapkido is very less known martial art. People know judo, karate, taekwondo, kung fu even, but hapkido most of the people do not know. So just what attempt of creating awareness about hapkido, we tried to organize this meet. Unfortunately, because it is holidays and summer vacation, most of the people have gone to native places, so we could not gather many people. But still, I think for sharing knowledge, whatever number of people are available is more than sufficient. Hapkido is Korean martial art. Other martial art like karate, taekwondo and all these things, they have turned into pure sports. But hapkido still is a purely martial art, though just recently competitions have also started. And hapkido is not into competition till now, because you know, when we talk about sports, a martial art or a combat art into sports, that means most of the techniques, I will say rather about 80% of the techniques are removed from the competition. And self-defense and competitions, like there is a main difference in that when you are doing competition, you are bound by many rules, regulations, do's and don'ts. But martial art doesn't have anything to do with that. In martial art, there is one rule. Since basically martial art is associated with your self-defense, so only one rule is there, that there is no rule. But hapkido has not come into sports aspect till now. The reason is that it is purely martial art. We are concerned more with the self-defense, safety of ourselves on the roadside. Though recently tournaments started, because some people realize that in today's times, if a martial art does not have the sports aspect, no competition, it takes a little more time to popularize it among public. That is why some competitions have started. Now, to give you exact idea of exactly the physical aspect of martial art, would like to show you a little video clip of hapkido, which had been shot in Korea. Some Korean people displaying the technique of hapkido. It is very unique martial art, hapkido, compared to any other art, because in other martial arts there are some limitations. Like some martial arts are just weapon oriented, some martial arts only kicks and punches, some martial arts just throws and all that. And there are some arts which I would not say martial art, but arts which have got healing and meditation touch. But hapkido has got everything in it. It has got kicks and punches, it has got throws, locks, chokes, strangulation, grappling techniques, standing, as well as lying down. So that is why martial art, this hapkido, is called a complete martial art. Please have this, can you see it? Even gymnastics is a part of hapkido.
Thank you.
So this might give you just a little bit idea of physical aspect of martial art, of hapkido rather. And of course physical aspect is very important, because this basically self-defense art, and you have to be physically very active. You have to learn all the techniques to be able to defend yourself. Now let's go to what is hapkido. First, let me explain. Hapkido basically is Korean martial art. It came into existence more than 1500 years before, when Korea was under, it was divided in under three kingdoms. It's what is hapkido? Hapkido, a martial art which was created with some philosophies. See, all the martial arts, they are always the result of some philosophies. Because if the martial art doesn't have the philosophy, a background, and rules and regulation, it becomes just hooliganism. Like, you know, road fight, gundagardi, so hum, you know, language they call it. Every martial art has to be controlled by some philosophy, spiritualism, and some rules and regulations. That is the reason they are called art. Otherwise, it will be just street fight. There is a lot of difference between a street fighter and a martial artist. A street fighter may be a hooligan, he may be a killer. But martial artist, he is an artist. He just tries to, he fights only to either to save himself or to save others. He doesn't fight to dominate other people and things like that. Now, as I said, in martial arts, they are always based on certain aspects. Like the art purpose, whenever art is created like hapkido, there is some purpose behind it. And as I told you, the basic purpose of any martial art is self-defense. Then other reasons can be good health, good character, and stable emotional stability. These are all the purposes of martial art. Then belief system. You have to believe in your art, you have to believe in the philosophies, please. And moral values. Moral values are very important in martial art, because as I said, if I become very good in fighting, I do not have any moral value, I do not have spirituality, I'll just become a gunda on the roadside. So if you have a cop, if you have power, there some should be some accountability, some authority over you. Otherwise a person, you know, may go out of control. So some moral values are added into martial art. And then philosophical principles, as I said, okay, every martial art has got some philosophical purposes, some background behind it. Without that, it will be just a martial way, not art. Art will not be there. Like in hapkido, next please. Hapkido, the name is a Korean name. It is a combination of three Korean words. One is hap, second is ki, third is do. Do is very important. You will find this do in many other martial arts like judo, karate do, aikido, taekwondo. This do is common to all these styles. Do means way. And this way is not just the way, it has got the whole philosophical background into the way. Hap means hapkido. Complete meaning of hapkido is the way of coordinating your inner power. Hap means coordination or bringing it together. Ki is the power, that physical power, mental power, spiritual power. And do is the way or method. So in hapkido, you learn how to coordinate your mental, physical as well as spiritual power together. This is the meaning of hapkido. Now, generally in martial arts, these martial arts are based on any of these seven points you can see over there. All the martial arts, any of these seven generally. And there are, you see, these are striking, like some martial arts which are based only on striking, then blocking, they have the blocking system also, you have to block, strike and all that. But then the third one is grappling. Striking and blocking, you can say karate, taekwondo, kung fu. Then there is grappling technique, standing on ground, you will find it in judo. Then weapons like ninjutsu and some of the kumdo ninjutsu, some of the Chinese martial arts. Then internal techniques, that is breathing, meditation, energy, ki development, that you will find in tai chi, Chinese martial art tai chi, and Indian yoga. then healing techniques. Healing is altogether a very different thing. For example, we talk about karate, and if you compare with these seven, what happened? If you compare with these seven principles, the seven base, you will find karate completes just initial 2 points. One is striking, second is blocking. When you talk about judo, it covers up the grappling, the third point, standing and groundwork. And you talk about Muay Thai, that martial art from Thailand, that covers the first and second, that is striking, blocking, and to some extent the fourth one, throwing. So mostly all the martial arts, they cover 2-3 points only. But hapkido has got everything. In hapkido you will find striking, in hapkido you will find blocking, in hapkido you will find grappling, both standing and ground. In hapkido there are very good throws. Hapkido has got different weapon systems. Then hapkido has got internal teaching, because a lot of hapkido has got about more than a dozen different ways of breathing techniques. Meditation is very important in hapkido, and key developing your key energy is considered to be very important in hapkido. Then there is healing art, because hapkido doesn't have only striking or breaking technique. A master or instructor of hapkido must know how to revive an injured person. So that comes in hapkido. So you can say practically all the 7 points are covered in hapkido, which is done by very few martial arts, very few, rare martial arts. Otherwise most of the martial arts, they cover only 2-3 or maximum 4 points of this. Next. Can you make it a little clear? Anyways, it is actually, I think, the repetition of whatever I said, that all other martial arts, they have some techniques, like some are based on kicking technique, some are based on kicking, punching, blocking, some are based on throws. If any other martial artist, like if a judo player starts learning hapkido, he will find one part which he will think, I have done this in judo. If a karate player comes and practices hapkido, he learns hapkido, he will feel, okay, something is there which I have done, that is punching and all that. If a taekwondo player comes and learns hapkido, he will feel that even his part is there. So hapkido satisfies each and every martial art. Every martial art is covered in hapkido. It has got long range of practice into it. Next. And basically for a hapkido player, like generally if you see in any martial art, if they teach you punch on the face, the martial artist will punch on the face. If they say kick in the abdomen or punch at the abdomen, he will do that. But for a hapkido player, if somebody says punch on the face, that will not be sufficient for him. He will say wear on face. Punch on the face is not sufficient. He will have to specify where to punch on the face, because hapkido mostly is concerned with the vital points. There are a lot of vital points in your body, and in hapkido all the kicks, strikes, they are targeted towards those vital points only, on those pressure points only. You cannot just blindly punch, you cannot just blindly kick anywhere. You have to attack on the precise point, accurately on that weak point. That is why in hapkido it is very helpful for weaker sex, like women, children, citizens, because in hapkido you don't require to be very strong, physically strong or height and build. Just with very average body, average power, average speed, you can knock out a person who is even 10 times more powerful than you. Now this, all the techniques you can compare with other arts also change. In hapkido, it is more scientific. It is not based on total power. Hapkido is more soft and hard style. Technique and science is very important into it. All the techniques are based on proper scientific methods. So that is why even the weaker person can apply it very easily. Now, for example, I'll show you the ways of releasing your wrist. If somebody holds your wrist, like obviously come here. If somebody holds your wrist, we all know that if very strong person holds the wrist of any weaker person, it's not possible to remove the hand. But using the hapkido methods, it is very easy to remove your hand. Like hold my hand, I'll just explain you how we do it. Like, he's quite healthy, strong boy. He's a boy, very young. Hold with full power. Now I'm going to remove my hand. You have to just see how much power I'm using or how much am I struggling to remove my hand. Use full power, full power. How much power do I use? Just watch again. Take note. Hold. Puri taakat lagao. Use full power. Yes. Now can anybody tell me how much power I used? Hold with full strength. This. Huh? Hold with that hand. Full power. You may think okay, actually he is my student. So you may think okay, he is allowing me to remove my hand, right? Huh? How? ऐसे करके पकड़ो. This way. Hold with both hands. Both hands, yeah. Yes. And now you're not using power. Use full power. Yes. Okay, fine. He is my student, so you may think that he is not holding me quite with power. So he may be helping me to remove my hand. But I will ask anybody from you who is, especially those who have not done martial art before. Can anybody come and try? I'll show you how to do it and then you try and yours. Try by yourself. Aapne martial art kiya ho pehle kabhi? Nahi to aap aa jaiye. Aiye aiye. Nahi nahi aiye try kijiye. Bahut zaruri hota hai ye sab. Abhi first let me explain first how to do it. Yahan khade rahiye. Come again. I'll just explain you the technique behind this. Hold. The very first thing is step forward, okay? After stepping forward, see this is the way he is holding. The first, after stepping forward, stretch your hand completely, all the fingers together separately completely, then turn your hand down, your palm facing down, then in the direction of this thumb just pull your hand outside. Don't pull it towards your body, just pull it outside your body. Watch again. Just step forward. One is stretch the hand completely, two turn it down and then pull it outside. Okay, turn. See, if you pull it towards your body, this is the limit and his hand can stretch up to here, so your technique fails here. So don't pull it towards the body, pull it outside.
Yeah,
now try again. Hold it with power. See, I'll hold. Now, wait with me. Pull it hard. Fingers should be separate. Okay. Now, I'm holding a little more with power, right? Yeah. Do it. Yeah. Now, tell everybody how much power you have to use.
No, nothing.
Somebody else, you can try. Because you know, you do it by yourself, then you get the idea exactly about the art. Trying by yourself will be more convincing. Otherwise, if you don't try, you'll have doubts. So, better somebody else want to try? Now, hapkido, come back to this discussion again. Now, hapkido provides complete physical conditioning. the way we practice hapkido. See, in any sports or any other system of exercise, the movements, different movements, they're not so much as much in hapkido. So the practice of hapkido provides the workout for each and every muscle, each and every ligament and tendon. That much complete workout no other system of exercise will be able to provide you. In the training, you become more flexible, you become faster, you become stronger, and you are well balanced, your body becomes balanced. I have seen that those people who practice hapkido, my own experience and the experience of other people, they rarely, it might have happened ke they fall down on the floor. If they're walking, the leg slips, immediately they recover. Many of my students told me, sir, after learning hapkido, we have not fallen down on the floor, even if the leg slips, because you learn to control your body. And that control is not physically only, control comes mentally also. Like a hapkido player on the road fight, he will not be able to be provoked so easily to start the fight. A layman, aap usko thoda sa kuch kar do, give him bad word, a little push, and he may start fighting again, fighting. But for a hapkido player, it's very difficult to provoke him to fight, because he's got so much power, control over himself. He's got a balanced personality. So it is not easy to provoke him. At any cost, he will always refuse to fight. And one of the reasons for this is the confidence level, because once you learn hapkido, you gain so much confidence. You have confidence on your abilities, you have confidence in yourself. Mentally, physically, you are fully confident, and a confident person cannot be provoked easily. A layman who doesn't know anything, he may start fighting, but not a hapkido player. Next. Now we go to history of hapkido. Hapkido came into existence about between 1500 to 2000 years back. In those time, since I told you earlier that this is from this martial art has been created in Korea. That time Korea was divided into three different kingdoms. One of the three kingdoms, which was known as Silla, was very small compared to other two. So being small kingdom, they were always attacked by the bigger two, and even attacked by the Japan. So they were very worried about their safety. So they created one system of fighting, which at that time they called it Warangdo. And the people who were practicing this so-called Warangdo, and that time this new fighting systems based on skills and science they created, and since the whole military was trained into that art, and basis of that art, they later on conquered other two kingdoms, and then Korea was united. Silla, Paekje, and Koguryo, three kingdoms were there. Then Silla, the smallest one, they created their own martial art, they became expert, and they fought, they conquered all other two kingdoms, and they make the whole one country, which is now known as Korea. That art in different times was known with different names, like Subak, Taekyon, Warangdo, and now it is Hapkido. But how it was given the name Hapkido? This gentleman, grandmaster, he is Mr. Choi Yong Sul. He is considered to be the modern founder of Hapkido. Modern founder, I am saying, because during the Japanese occupation of Korea, he was a child. In 1910, Japan occupied that Korea. They banned all the martial arts who were there. And that time it was a system like Korean children were taken to Japan for working as a worker and maid and all that. So even this guy was taken to Japan, and fortunately his foster father in Japan was Takeda Sensei. I think if some of you are doing jujutsu, anybody doing jujutsu? No one. Takeda Sensei was the grand master of Aiki Jujutsu. I think you have done Jujutsu, right? He was the grand master and very expert. He became the foster father of Mr. Choi Yong Sul. And Choi Yong Sul, for 30 years, he practiced under Takeda Sensei. After the death of Takeda Sensei, he went back to Korea. Then whatever he had learned from Aiki Jujutsu, he combined it with many, many Korean martial arts and gave it the name first useful, and then after refining, finally he gave it the name of hapkido. And then hapkido became very famous. Now today hapkido is so famous all over the world that it is called the art of 21st century. And it is being taught in Korea to all the military. It's compulsory over there. And many of the black hat commandos and all those, were some very important departments even in America. Even in America, many of the presidential bodyguards in America, they are also learning hapkido. At many countries, in many countries, the high-ranking bodyguards and departments like black hat commanders and all that, they are being trained in hapkido. Next. He is my teacher. His name is Grandmaster Song Su Lee. He was the first person in the world to become a 9th degree black belt in taekwondo and a 9th degree black belt in hapkido as well. He was the first person. Now 2-3 more people have come with this degree. 9th degree is the final or last degree in hapkido and taekwondo, though in some Japanese forms, in some Japanese martial arts, 10th degree is considered to be the highest form of degree. But in Korean martial arts, 9th is considered to be highest, because the general thinking is that the highest number is 9. After 9, whatever numbers are there, they are just repetitions of the numbers from 0 to 9. Highest single number is 9. That is why 9th degree in Korean degree is called Dan. 9 Dan is considered to be the highest degree of hapkido and in taekwondo. So he was the first person to get a 9th degree black belt in taekwondo as well as in hapkido. Another thing that he is the founder of one style of hapkido. Hapkido has got some different styles also, and he created one style. It's known as Mu Hakkwan, which is recognized by Korea Hapkido Federation. Korea Hapkido Federation is the largest hapkido organization in the world, and that Korea Hapkido Federation has recognized his system as one of the styles of hapkido, which is called Mu Hakkwan. The Mu Hakkwan, again Korean word, three words, Mu, Hak and Kwan. Mu means martial art, Hak means learning, and Kwan means school. So Mu Hakkwan means school of learning martial arts, which we are trying to promote in India. It was born in 1936, I think, or 1938. Next. And he is considered to be one of the best teachers of martial arts in the world. Recently, I was reading one American magazine on martial arts. So one American black belt who traveled all over the world, and he trained under different martial arts of those countries. He was interviewed by that magazine. I was just reading. So he was asked the question, you have traveled so much all around the world and trained under so many grandmasters, whom do you consider as the best teacher? So he said, of course, it is Grandmaster Song Su Lee. Now he is residing in Australia. He is a Korean, but on the invitation of Australian government, he was sent by WTF to Korea, this Australia. He was teaching over there, and now he is settled over there. Next. Next. We have done this. Next. Next. No, we have done all this. We have covered this. Okay, forget. Anyways, these were the all theories. Now we have the classes at many states and cities in India. We have formed the Hapkido Federation. Now we are very keen in promoting this hapkido in our country, and especially to the ladies and senior citizens, because as I told you, hapkido does not require much power. Just little bit of power, you can do a lot of things. In hapkido, since it has got much to do with pressure points. If you just punch somebody or press somebody, try to twist the hands or legs, it will be very difficult. But in human body, there are certain vital points over which slight pressure or even a slight hurt will cause a lot of pain. And bas isko rehne do. And that causes a lot of problem for the opponent, and you can control him. Now, hapkido is, there are three principles of hapkido. It's a basic philosophy of hapkido. One is non-resistance. Second is circle principle. Third is water. Now, non-resistance, or you can call it harmony. Non-resistance is that you come. Hapkido, as I told you, is not based on power. It is based on skills and technique. And very important of this is non-resistance. So for a hapkido player, if you push him, he will never resist. Like you might have seen, if you push somebody, the person uses the power back. This is against the principle of hapkido. Non-resistance, like if he pushes me, if he pushes, I'll move back. I will not resist. If he pulls me, pull, I will go forward. I will not resist. If he pushes me to this side, I will move over there. That is the principle of hapkido. Why? Because in hapkido, power against power is considered to be wrong. Now, what happens if he's going to push me again? This. How much power do I have to apply? If I use my own power, what will happen? If he is more powerful, he will defeat me. If I am more powerful, I'll defeat him. Hapkido is not all about that. Hapkido is on technique. Now again, 1 minute. Okay, fine. If he pushes me, now come slow. If he's trying to push me, I just move on side. Now helping him again and then kick. So my own power plus his power. It gives triple, even four or five times more greater impact that knocks him out. This is non-resistance. Again, another thing, like if push your hand here, and he is pushing me. Instead of resisting, push me, I just go to throw him. Now here I don't have to use my power. These are the principles. If you understand, it will be very easy for you to tackle any opponent. Now next principle is circle principle. In Korean it is called won. All the techniques of hapkido are based on circle. It is small circle or big circle. Like he is holding my hand, I have to control him or put him into some torture position. The technique which I use is circular. Circle. Now he is coming for a punch. I have to defend myself. Punch. Take him into lock. This is a circle. Because when you use circle, creating circle either with hands or body, even with body, again it's coming for the punch, I move in a circular motion and I can throw him or take him into the lock. When you are using circular movement, you are using your body's momentum at its best. And what is power in martial art? See, definition of power differs with every sport and every art. In martial art, power is you might have read in a school, in physics, there is one formula: mass into acceleration is equal to power. Right? So mass is body weight, acceleration is speed. When you combine them together, your body weight plus your speed, you create power. And when you are moving into circle, you are combining your speed and your body momentum together. So that way you are creating more and more power. That is circle principle. Next is water or flexible principle. Thank you. Thanks. Water principle is very famous in hapkido. A hapkido person has to be as soft as water. You just press water, it goes in, it moves with side, it gives you the wave. But when the water comes back, like you all remember the tsunami and all that, or in 2005, kuch flood bhi aaya tha Bombay mein. So water is the softest thing. You just press, you put a hand, put anything, it gives away. But when there is a backlash from the water, nothing can stop it. Another thing of water is the, like when water is flowing, you put something, any stone or anything, water does not stop over there. And it does not push it with full power. The very first thing the water does, you put any obstacle, any stone, it just moves inside and surrounds the thing. The same way, hapkido person has to be there. He has to be soft as well as very hard. When he is soft, when somebody is pushing or attacking, like as I said, move back, go with the attack. You have to be that soft. But when there is a backlash from you, counter attack, it has to be very hard. And the flow of water, when it is flowing, whatever you put, it doesn't stop. That way the technique of hapkido has to be continuously a flow, continuous flow. One technique after that, second, then third, then fourth, continuously you have to do till the opponent drops down or he is totally under your control. These are the three very famous principles of hapkido. The whole hapkido is based on that. Next. Now this is about the ki power. Chinese call it chi power, and Japan ki power, or some in Chinese also called it ki also, qi or ki, or chi power, chi. These, according to these Japanese, Korean and Chinese philosophy, ki is the energy force, life force. They believe that this is the force, a power which is there everywhere. Every person has got this power, the power of this chi power, it keeps flowing through your whole body. And those who control this chi power, they are able to perform the miracles. And chi is completely continuously flowing in your body. When there is an interruption into the flow of power, that chi power, then wherever, like if the interruption is here in the liver, then you have got some problem with the liver. If it is in the heart, then you have the problem with the heart. So if there is any obstruction in the flow of chi power, you become sick, and accordingly those people, they healed. And there are 12 meridians, 12 points in the body through which the chi keeps on flowing. And controlling of the this ki power, one of the best way is called tanjun. Next is tanjun. What tanjun? Tanjun is a breathing system in hapkido. If somebody is trying to control the ki power, he has to do a lot of breathing exercises. First with the breathing, and tanjun, this point, tanjun breathing. Basically tanjun is a point in the body which is unseen, but it is believed that it is about 3 inches below your navel point. It is located over there. When you do tanjun exercise with the breathing, you try to feel the location of that tanjun place. And continuous daily dedicated practice of this breathing system throughout months and years together, then you start feeling the location of tanjun, and then the ki power comes into control. Next. Now these are the vital points of different bodies. As I said, ki hapkido. In hapkido, you don't attack anybody blindly anywhere. You have to attack on some specific points. So in hapkido, there are many weak points in the body. They are taught to all the students. Now these weak points, so vital pressure points, basically they were discovered for the purpose of healing. Those experts of these pressure points, they used to heal it. You might have heard those system of acupressure and acupuncture, acupressure. There they either puncture or press those vital points and heal people. But then later on it was discovered that the same points can be used to injure anybody. So after there are about 364 vital points in human body, and hapkido people use about 200 of these points for attacking and all that. Now the example of this, come on. As I said, these pressure points stand here. Now somebody is holding my neck. I use one hapkido technique, just here, and using only these two fingers, press this. Not much power, only pressing this point. Come here. That pressure point is lying here. There is a muscle here. Under this muscle, this pressure point lies. Now it is covered by these muscles. Most of these pressure points are not just open. Most of them are covered by the muscles or other joints. What you have to do is turn this hand. When the hand is turned, this muscle shifts. When the muscle is shifted, this point is exposed. Putting these two fingers here, push it upward and press this. This is one lock. Second thing, again, somebody holding. In many arts, this technique is taught like this. It's very effective, no doubt. But at the advanced level, these all things are performed using the pressure point again. Now, any hapkido player, even at the advanced level, he may do this technique this way. But a master of hapkido instructor, he knows that this grip is not just holding the wrist, but thumb will be here. There is a point here, exactly here. When you press it, it pains a lot. So when I hold him, my one thumb is over there. I press. Now here only the person is in pain. Next is just formality. So same way there are many other points. Another thing, come on, is holding this. There is a nerve point over here. You might have felt some, many of you, when you press, you feel something. If you press, there is some rope, something little rope like you're getting crushed. It moves here. That is a nerve point. You hold somebody, it lies here only. Just stretch your fingers. This bony part is exposed. With this, put your hand here, press. And if you do it with full power, you can break the bone also. So these are these vital points which you use. Then another thing, again, like somebody holding me, I have to just push him. I just hold here, one hand here, and push. So it is just a pressure, using the pressure point. Now here I don't have to use much power. Even if the person is more stronger than me, if I go for full body power, if he is more stronger than me, he will defeat me. Then I have to go for the pressure points, because I know that a person is stronger, I cannot control with just merely physical power. So I have to go on this. Even the ladies, you can see, as I'll just explain again earlier, which hand release I had done. Yeah, how much power I use it? Puri taqat lagao bhai. This, how much power I have to use? This, hold with this. This I'm repeating for some people who came late. Yeah. This, you just see how much power am I using. Hold with both hands. This, hold it this way. This, yeah. Hardly 10 or 15% of power I'm using. If on my place there is a lady, how much power she will use? 30%, 40, 50, 60%. Even if you have to use 50 or 60% of your power, it's very easy deal. You can even knock out person who is much more stronger than you. So these all are pressure points. Now with this also, as I said, pressure points and the joints, you are putting the joints into unnatural bend. So that is why it is very easy to release. Then, as I said, another thing, he's holding my hand. Now if I have to just kick him or just control him, this, there is a point here, I have to just press here, he goes down. Another point, once I was talking to some people, actually some people from underworld like that. So they were telling ke, you know, they have got the all ghodas and all that weapon, and they can kidnap anybody. What they have to do is just put the gun here, and the person voluntarily comes with them if they want to kidnap. I said, if I have to kidnap somebody, then I don't need the guns. I just do some movements and happily he will come with me. Not happily, but at least he'll have to come. They were asking how. I said, see, different locks are there. Now, so for example, this, I do this. Into this lock, if you resist, it will pain you a lot. This is just a demonstration. Don't resist much. Now, here if I have to take him, he will come with me. He can't resist. I'll press this. He'll have to come. Now he can't refuse me. I can take him wherever I want. And they say in our language, "Oh, toh uchal uchal kar aayega." There is one film actress, Isha Kopikar. Some people might have heard about her. She's my student. She is a black belt in Taekwondo. Once we were into a press conference of self-defense. So one journalist asked me a question. After the conference was over, so she said, "Sir, you show me some tricks. I want to beat up my boyfriend." I said, "But why want to beat up your boyfriend?" She said, "Kini, if you are standing in the party, I tell him to come and he doesn't listen to me. So I want to do something. I'll beat him and he'll come with me." I said, "Instead of beating, I'll show you some techniques. You hold him. You take him forcefully. But only your boyfriend will know that you're using force against him and he's going out of against his wish. Other people will think, haan, bechari kitne pyar se lekar ja rahi hai." So she said, "Yes, sir, show me that." I said, "Just this way. Suppose your boyfriend, he's not my boyfriend, of course. I'm just showing." So you just go, "Come on, darling, let's go. Hold the hand this way. Back of the palm, inside your palm, this way. Ab aise pakadne hai, to it feels ki haan bhai, ladki ne kitne pyar se apne boyfriend ko pakda hua hai. And take him. Only he knows how he is walking. It's pressing in and this joint, press it out, he'll have to walk." These things are found in hapkido. In no other martial art you will find all these things. Very easily you can control a person. In other martial arts, like generally if you have some of you are martial artists and anybody who have attended the martial arts self-defense seminars, generally what is being taught in, especially to the ladies, what they teach you, if you are alone on like late night, if you are walking alone on the street, somebody comes, they show you how to kick and punch, kick or punch and run away. Most of the things I have seen in Taekwondo, Karate, Kung Fu, they teach this way. But the problem which personally I feel is that when such situation arises, you're walking alone on the late night in a dark state, so naturally a lady will be little nervous. And if somebody comes, she becomes more nervous. And in that state, if she strikes, that will not have any effect, because it is done out of fear, and still she runs away. What happens? The reaction of that, he is a male. If a lady strikes him and runs away, two things happens. First thing, you strike, his male ego is hurt. Ladki ne mujhe mara. Second thing, she is running away. So he is more confident. She is running away means she is scared. So little bit of nervousness which he may have, wo bhi chala jayega, and then he will run after the girl, and what he will make her to do, you all can imagine. But in hapkido, now this is taught in some general martial arts where there is limitation. We can just kick, strike, nothing else. But in hapkido, it's not, as I told you, it is a complete martial art. There is no restriction. In hapkido, you can control the person. If you don't want to seriously damage him, you can control him. Like, suppose he is coming, I told you just now, certain techniques I showed you. Like, if he is coming, he holds my hand, right? Instead of hitting and all that, just do this. He is under your control. Now, instead of running, take him to the police station. You can do that easily. So many different techniques are there. Another thing, there is one technique which is called fixing. Throws are there in hapkido. Very easy throws. You throw somebody, pin him down, and fixing techniques are there. You just apply to them. Even if he's 10 times more powerful, then he will not be able to come out of your grip. And then you can shout for help and all that. There is no need to run away. Running away creates a lot of problem. But these are physical techniques. Now martial art, especially hapkido, is not only about the physical techniques. It prepares you mentally also. Now, I think everybody must be knowing about the case recently, few months back, it happened in Delhi, the rape case in Delhi. I was conducting a seminar, and somebody asked me, give me the example of Delhi incident. He said the girl was raped over there. She was in the bus, one boyfriend, but there are six males. Now, even if you're a girl who may be very good at kicks and punches, she cannot fight young men, six, together in a bus where very limited space is there. You cannot use all your kicks and punches. Even if she were a good martial, although that girl was not a martial artist, she was just a lay girl. They said that even if she were a good martial artist, she would not have defended herself. The same thing would happen. I said, she is not a martial artist. If she would have gone under training of a good martial art teacher, she would have been saved. The thing is that you are thinking only kicks, punches, fighting, throwing and all that. Martial art is not just about that. It has got much more to offer. Like, you have to think, you have to make your mind active. If she was a girl, that girl would have trained by a good qualified martial artist. And I'll tell you, because in our country, more than 80% martial art instructors are fake, unqualified. If she would have been trained by a qualified martial art instructor, he would have told her, okay, in this situation where you can't do anything, you know that those six men are there, they're going to rape you, you can't fight back anything, then the best way is insert your finger in your mouth, in your throat, and vomit. Vomit on yourself, not outside. And you all can imagine, a person is coming to a woman with some bad intentions and all vomit is scattered all over her body, what he'll do? कोई भी आके नहीं बढ़ेगा, I think छोड़ देंगे सब लोग. At the most, what they will do? कि चलो ठीक है, उनका लस पूरा नहीं हुआ, angry, बहुत गुस्से में होंगे. They will throw her out from the bus, running train. But then that is exactly what they did. उन लोगों ने यही किया, but after torturing her so much. एक डेढ़ दो घंटा उसको टॉर्चर किया, एवरी काइंड ऑफ टॉर्चर दे यूज, एंड देन दे थ्रू हर आउटसाइड द बस. अगर शी वुड हैव डन दिस, खाली उसको फेंक देते बाहर, मे बी सम ब्रूजेज, एक गद फ्रैक्चर, एंड शी वुड हैव बीन लाइव वेल. तो दिस इज द थिंग्स विच इज टॉट इन मार्शल आर्ट. इट्स नॉट ओनली फिजिकल, यू हैव टू यूज योर माइंड. एंड इन मार्शल आर्ट, वट इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट इन हापकिडो इज अवेयरनेस. इन डेली, यू ऑल नो atmosphere of Delhi, I think just after evening when there is that, no, girls are generally do not go out. When you know the situation, it's better to avoid, you should not go out. And then when you're climbing in the bus, you know that there are six men, there is not a single woman, don't climb into that bus. So this is called awareness. Wherever you go, it's not that main yahan par aake baith gaya, I'm just seeing these things aur bas jitna bolna hai. I have to be aware of everything. Here kitni kursiyan lagi hain, kitne log baithe hain, how many people are there, what is there, wahan se kaun aa sakta hai, down what is there, everything you have to notice. When you're climbing in the bus, you should know before stepping into the bus, you should know how many people are standing over there, how many, you don't have to literally count everybody, but you should know generally who are good, who are bad. If you have to pass through some way, you should see that some wrong person is not there. So everything you have to notice. That is very important way of avoiding the danger. In martial art, it's not that you defeat the person. What is more important is to avoid that confrontation. These we teach you all how to kick and punch and all that. That is as the last resort. When you have done everything to avoid the confrontation, you have done everything to avoid that threat and everything, but still nothing has worked, then at the last moment you start kicking and punching whatever you have learned. That comes into use at the end. But before that, it is all mental. 90% of the fights or such type of confrontations can be avoided just through by being aware of the situation. Just try to be aware. make your mind active. And martial art is one of the best things to make your mind active, because it basically creates harmony between mind and body. So they both start working together. Next. Weapons in hapkido. As I said, hapkido covers all aspects of martial art. There are weapon fights also in hapkido. There are about 36 weapons in hapkido. Generally, we teach, these are very commonly known, like knife. In hapkido, we teach how to fight with a knife. Then short stick is there, medium stick, long stick. Then there is fan. There is rope. My ladies can very well use a dupatta and short stick, and then walk a stick there. Yeah, walking cane. They can be very easily used. Now this walking cane is, it is generally used by the senior citizen. Jo our belief in India ke bhai senior ho gaya, jab inko lakdi lekar chalna padta hai, they can't even walk on themselves, so how can they fight? But I tell you, in hapkido there are so many very good techniques where you can very easily use the stick and defeat any powerful person, and that too without using much power. Now suppose I'm here standing, he comes with a punch, right? Yeah. What I have to do, thoda sa idhar aa ja. Yeah. He comes with a punch. I just taking one step back here, hold the hand, move here. Now this lock, see here it is elbow lock. I just press this. How much power am I using? Just minimum. Come with this left hand. Left hand punch now. Again moving back. Put here. Just lift this part. He's going down. We don't have to use much power. And the easy thing which everybody can imagine. Samne khada hai. Just strike here on the tip, or maybe when he is coming to attack, come this you can imagine very well. But to control him is also very easy. Now just these two techniques of shooting. Come again. Yeah, left se punch lo. As I said, you have to just strike hard here, and after this 1, 2 hold the hand and lift this part. Even if he is powerful person, he will go down. Second thing, these are the techniques. Now suppose if he holds me, I'm holding this, he catches. Some people may think aapka danda pakad gaya or gone, because you're a senior citizen with all her white hair. But hold this hand here and turn this. So that's all. Not using much power. Or holding again his hand, strike this. Sorry. So these are very good thing. Another thing, this is walking cane. Thank you. Now small stick. There are many martial arts which you might have seen using like Filipino martial art. They have about 30 inches of stick. Medium stick, long stick, they are there in hapkido. But I prefer, this is my favorite weapon, because this is small. You can carry it. Lambe stick aap lekar kahin nahi ghum sakte. This you can ladies ke purse mein bhi aa sakta hai. Aur kuch bhi nahi hota, at least have a chances that in fight koi aise choti si stick you may find lying on the road. This stick was actually specially created to fight against the sword. But this is also very good weapon. Now ye aise hai jaise pakadne. Earlier I showed you the technique, this using this pressure point. The same thing can be done using this, and since this is wood, so it will have more effect. Gala pakad ye gala pakad. Okay, fine. Instead of using the finger, use this one. Then I showed you earlier this technique, pressing this one, the nerve here. This you can press with a stick. And there are, of course, there strikes, like somebody comes to punch with hand, it might be difficult for a lady or for a senior citizen, but slow enough, otherwise you will get hurt. When he comes, you can strike here. Now striking on the vital point, 1, 2, on the temple, or you can strike on the hand, you can strike here, you can strike here. Now, hand techniques, striking with the hand, with the punch may be difficult, but striking with this, striking on the vital points, you can strike here on the solar plexus, you can strike on the liver, you can strike on the spleen, you can strike on the throat. Just average your hand momentum, that's all. You don't have to be very powerful, just swing it and you get him. There are so many techniques with this, using on all the vital points, you can knock out any person. Next, and rope technique, sorry, anybody has got belt or rope? No, no, not this belt, oh, karate ka belt hota or anything. Ajay, shall we belt, huh? Knee down there. Okay, give me this belt only. This technique can be, oh, very hard. Can be performed with the rope, with this belt, with dupatta, of course. You can just open this scarf and use it. If somebody attacks it, as I told you, that in hapkido, you don't have to use force against force. Now, if he's going to attack, move back. Don't go forward either. You move on side or you move back. Give him the way. As I told you, in water, when you put hand, what water does, it gives the way for you to go in. The same way, give him the way to come in. When he is coming with his own flow, you can take him down here, down, and the same, you can just tie him, take him to the police station wherever you want. There are so many techniques. You can literally throw him and tie him completely and leave him and go to inform the police. Yeah. Or then common objects. Yes, this is very important. A common object, any common object can be turned into weapon. Like, you know, suppose this is a pen marker. Jo, I have shown you that short stick, that can be used. The same principle can be used with this. You can strike, but with these things, just try to strike on the soft part of the body. You can hold, it should be just sudden. Strike here, but when you strike, don't stop. You have to feel as if you have to penetrate. Your hand should go up to here. Just strike here. You can strike in the eye. You can strike on the this lip. On the lip. Yeah. These parts, this one is there. Aapko watch hai. This. Ye aap le lein. Isse ye kar lein. Strike in the eye. And the best thing is, yeah, got it. This is as deadly as a knife. आप लोगों में से कैन एनी बडी बिलीव दैट आई कैन कट इट लाइक अ नाइफ? नहीं, आप लोग तो सिखा चुका हूँ आप लोगों को, बट एनी बडी, इट कैन वर्क एज अ नाइफ. इट कैन लिटरली कट द बॉडी दो, एंड इट विल बी मोर पेनफुल देन द नाइफ, बिकॉज नाइफ और ब्लेड वॉट एवर कट, एक स्लैश कर देते हैं इमीजिएटली कट जाता है, लेकिन ये जो कटता है इट इज़ पेनफुल, क्योंकि ये आपके स्किन को पूरा उधेड़ते लगता है. नाउ दोज हू डू नॉट बिलीव दैट दिस कैन वर्क एज अ knife, I'll tell you, I'll just show you the way of handling. I'll put it at the place and you also will believe it can cut, right? That's it. Come on, hold it this way. Any comb can be used this way. Now I'll just keep it at the place and you tell me whether I'll be able to cut that place or not. Here, can I cut? Ho jayega cut ya nahi? Yahan se just press, you can literally cut. Hold it this way and aise khade raho. Yeah. Putting it here, just between nose and the lip, on the base. Yeah, yeah. And this way, you can literally cut it. Or thoda sa funny jaisa lagega, but aise khade raho. Kahin kuch zyada deadly position hai, ye lijiye. Cut. It really acts like a knife and it is very painful. When you cut using this one, this is very painful.